Episode
90. Wow, this is a doubleheader.
This is a doubleheader, dude. We're just ripping the fuck out. Well, people won't know. Hey, you know what? Yeah, we're gonna
let them know.
We're gonna make it. These episodes are gonna rain.
We're gonna release this same time as 89.
Yeah, man.
All right, I'm like,
maybe I'll pepper today. People don't know. People, we're talking from the future. People, don't, you know what I'm saying?
I don't even know.
I don't know what's going on.
Matt's
dude.
Out here. Fucking,
we're 20
dude,
seconds in.
There's a master plan that Matt has that I'm just along for the ride, dude.
The storm's coming.
I basically just latched onto a dragon's wings, and I'm just letting this thing ride, dude. I'm like Daenerys.
You are Daenerys. You're strong.
And
I
found
sure.
you as an egg, dude. I grew you into a monster giant.
Mother of dragons.
I'm just
dragons,
on your back, just like, I don't know where he's taking me. But I feel like we can conquer a kingdom.
You can't trust dragons, dude.
I trust dragons.
Hell yeah, dude.
That's why they fear
us. You speak
us.
Fucking.
I speak.
Well, now I'm getting Harry Potter now.
I speak McCusker.
You do, dude.
I know
you
how
do
to,
speak McCusker.
I speak McCusker.
My boy Spud was telling me that. I was like, so we're talking about you in New York. And I was like, yeah, well, it's like, it sucks. Because, like, I would just come here and try to do an episode by myself, but no one would have any fucking idea what I'm saying. And he's like, yeah, you kind of got to be with you in person to understand what you're talking about, dude. He's
yeah.
like, because you kind of go off on a weird trails and shit. I was like, I need my fucking handler, bro.
Well, I also
need my Wrangler.
I also got up there and I'm doing that show. It's called A Fair One. It's on Compound Media. Mm-hmm. But I've been doing this so long that I feel like this is what my co-host is like.
Yeah.
So like Tommy will say shit and I'll be like, you're not gay, are you? Like I'll say shit that I know you would be like, fuck no, dude. Like I know, I'll be like, what do you think about that?
Yeah.
And I know there's a definite answer.
Yeah.
With Tommy, I'll be like, what do you think about that? I'll be like, what? What are you talking about?
I was like, oh, my guess, man.
All right, anyway.
Fuck, man. That's hilarious. What?
Yeah, what?
What are you talking about?
Why would you say that? Anyway, we're joined by a longtime friend of the show.
Yeah.
Very alt-left comedian. He's been banned from several mics. We might talk about that.
That'd be tight.
Yeah, we can go into that. But anyway, this is James Masciulli, everybody. James Masciulli.
How you doing, guys?
One of the hottest political acts in the Philadelphia comedy scene.
Your mic's on, Masciulli?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. How dare I, dude? Masciulli, actually, a little background,
yeah.
is basically, you know, much of the reason why this shit doesn't pop and crackle every 5 seconds. He's a total guru of sound.
He's a sound guy. That's one of your jobs, right?
Yeah.
You edit podcasts and shit?
Yeah.
In
yeah,
honor of them. You, I'm going to fuck with these knobs here and see if this works out. What's good, bro?
So what happened was we just recorded an episode, sick episode in the studio.
Great episode, dude.
Dude, we're pretty much like Dre and Pac in the studio.
Pretty much.
This is like Death Row Records.
Did
we walk out.
Did I tell you ruined Tupac for me now?
What, did he shot that 6-year-old
yeah,
in the head?
Yeah, I can't listen to him anymore.
Yeah, it's bullshit.
My alarm was hit him up. I'd wake up. I was like, that's why I fucked you, bitch, you fat. Britney fucking hates it, dude.
Yeah, it is hilarious.
But now, like, that, I like the song Hearts of Men, and like that was on my phone. I'm like, I can't even fucking listen to this,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, shot a 6-year-old in
I
the
can't,
head.
I can't even listen anymore. As soon as it's on, I'm like, I feel like a piece of shit.
So I looked it up more into that. The 6-year-old wasn't at the event.
Mm-hmm.
The stray bullet hit a little kid on a bike in the neighborhood.
Did he die?
Yeah.
Oh,
got
man.
Shot in the head. They gave the family $500,000 to settle out of court. 500 grand.
This sucks, man.
Because you couldn't charge him with murder because it was like, it was a stray bullet.
He dropped a gun.
Yeah.
He really dropped, did guns really go off like that?
Well, when the security guard picked it up.
So he dropped it, a security
he
guard.
He pulled his gun on someone.
Yeah.
Dropped it. When somebody in his entourage tried to pick it up, it fired. Hit a little kid, a 6-year-old on a bike. In the fucking
Jesus,
head.
Jesus, man.
Kid should have been wearing a helmet. Anyway. Where you know what's funny about that Hit 'Em Up song? As a fat guy and a Notorious fan.
Yeah.
I always hated that opening line.
That's why I fucked your bitch, you fat motherfucker.
Every time I heard that, I'd be like, all right, fuck you, dude. Fuck's your problem.
I mean, maybe he fucked your bitch, dude. You don't know.
If Tupac fucked my bitch, that'd be sick. Because that means he fucked like a 5-year-old.
True, yeah, at that time.
Killed a 6-year-old, fucked a 5-year-old. This guy's on
like
a roll.
I feel like Tupac would fuck your bitch real hard, dude.
Yeah, it'd be tough.
Tupac also might fuck your bitch against her will, allegedly.
Well, he also was a part of that.
Allegedly, he might.
There was a chick who got...
That's why I fucked your bitch. It's like, well, you snuck upon her when she was getting to her car.
Yeah,
that doesn't really count.
That's why I fucked your bitch and I gang raped your bitch in a hotel room. And then I feel bad about it.
And that's why I fucked your bitch and served my time. After getting prosecuted for raping.
This is nice. This is a good smear campaign on Pac, dude. I like it.
You know
it.
What, man? I'm all about posthumous smear campaigns. That's how you do it, man. Pick a famous dead guy and be like, fuck him.
Led Zeppelin chained a fucking 17-year-old in a closet or some shit. I don't know.
Mischuli, how do you feel about
James
that?
James Mischuli.
Good, good. I believe it was something like they they had like a crawfish or something, and they like put it in her vagina.
In a teenager's vagina?
Yeah. But,
wait, Led Zeppelin put a crawfish in a teenager's vagina?
And that's how they got the audio for Immigrant Song. That was her at the beginning.
But I've also heard that was just like a story that, you know, got around.
Yeah. So anyway, let's talk, dude. The reason we brought him in is because he was out on the couch in the living room spouting off about how much he hates the right. And Matt almost fought him. I had to pull Matt off him.
Please.
He got into your guard. Matt almost put him in. And then we're like, you know what? Let's get you on the mic. Let's hear these. So you're an extreme liberal. You're a fucking alt left.
You're a terrorist.
You're a socialist.
How did this come about? Because you got pretty much banned for people thinking you were an alt right figure.
Well, I don't do like identity politics and that type of shit. I mean, I always thought I was like an extreme leftist, and then like the last couple years, I'm like, oh, I guess I'm pretty center.
Think the welcome.
Everybody
back.
Thinks they're center, dude. You're a fucking communist. Don't you like communism?
I don't exactly know what you mean by communism.
Okay, yeah, that's a fucking communist response.
My eyes just went red, dude.
Yeah, I don't even. Interview's over, dude.
Well, how do you feel about Trump talking to Putin?
I prefer to call my more like a unionist. You know.
You're a unionist.
Yeah.
So what's that mean?
It means he read.
That means he's got to pay someone $300 to sweep my fucking floor. Get out of here. Get him out.
That means he read Grapes of Wrath and is like, that's pretty much me. I'm Tom Joad.
Are you TJ?
Oh, I wish.
Are you? How often do you listen to Rage Against the Machine and just be like, yo, this is social injustice?
pretty often.
What's Rage Against the Machine's new stuff like?
The only thing I've heard him on, what's that guy's name?
Zach.
Oh yeah.
What's his name?
De La Roca.
Dak De La Roca.
Yeah, I've only heard him on Run the Jewels.
What's his shit now? Like capitalism, sweet.
Yeah, I know.
I got 50 mil.
Again, as soon as I googled his net worth, I was like, oh well, Rage Against the Machine sucks.
Yeah.
But
well, I mean, they probably use that money to like, you know,
if you're gonna be a fucking staunch social justice warrior and then capitalize and have millions and millions of dollars, it's like, yeah, well, shut the fuck up about social injustice.
What do you think about that?
I mean, it's definitely a complicated issue. Well, I mean, people say the same thing about like the Clash, but it's like, I mean, I'm sure those people do good things with their money, and it's like, I think music and stuff's weird because it's like you do want to. Even if like their music wasn't political, it's like you still want to reach a mass audience in some way. Like you want people to like appreciate your work.
Yeah.
I mean, like if you talk about the imbalance between like what like we pay entertainers compared to other things, it's definitely like,
I'm with you on that. I hate the fact that entertainers get a lot of money. Entertainers should get paid maybe 80 grand a year.
What they should get is $80 a month on their Patreon. That's what entertainers should get, according to the market.
That's
according
true.
According to the market, you and me are worth about $65 a month.
That's pretty fair.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with that.
That's not bad. That's like that's like half of an Xfinity cable package.
True. Dude, if you have listened to every episode and aren't on the Patreon, you can fucking suck a dick.
Yeah, dude.
It's fucked up.
Well, they know, man. This is all bleeding together.
You can't
fucking
log in and give us a dollar, you sack of shit.
I think a dollar. Just if they just do something. I didn't know Patreon. Well, it's a subscription, so it's a dollar, but it's like it's coming to do. The globalists hate when you fucking fund the Patreon, dude.
The globalists definitely hate.
Are you
the
a globalist, Mischuli?
I don't think so.
Don't you want
typical globalist?
Yeah, he's dude. This is the most globalist.
You should have said fuck no. I ain't no motherfucking pedophile.
Are you a pedophile?
I hope not. I mean, no.
What? So what's going on with you, Michels?
Nothing much. Just, you know, hanging out.
Oh, man. Michels.
Michels, if you were the president, what's the first thing you would do?
Probably fuck. I don't like.
You would fuck?
Oh, yeah.
Fuck?
I don't like. I kind of don't get
First
like,
lady, hopefully.
Well, no, like, I don't, like, he's supposed to be the most powerful man in the world, right? And you're like, oh, he fucks just one, like,
Oh,
it's very, you know what I mean? Very postmodern of you, dude. You think very... it should be poly? And obviously he doesn't. He's had to settle out of court with mad porn stars, yeah. Dude. So.
Donald Trump definitely fucks a ton of fucking chicks.
Donald Trump probably just fucks men just because every now and again. He's definitely fucked at least one man somewhere. Just a fucking, like, you know, the board of directors was like, I'll tell you how it's going to be. Fucking, ugh.
You think?
If you're a billionaire, you've definitely fucked a man at least once. Out of, just out of, like, just to keep order.
You were in the office late. Janitor walks by. You're like, get in here. Get the fuck in here.
You always have, like, your little flask. You're always, like, kind of, like, disastrously drunk at the end of the day. Yeah. And you're like, hey.
Come in some janitor's butt and then make him sign a fucking non-disclosure act. Be like, if you say anything, I'll fucking kill your whole family. Get the fuck out of here.
He was on Epstein's plane.
Lolita Express. He was on it.
Trump was on the pedophile plane?
Yeah, Lolita Express. Probably just gathering intel, dude.
Most likely gathering intel.
He was on, I mean, that's the other thing, too, man. Imagine that. They're like, yo, I got this plane. We're going to an island full of, what were they? How old were the girls?
I've 16, never really, 17? Like, read into any of that.
Yeah, because it's anti-Clintons, and you love the Clintons.
You love the Clintons?
Oh, no, I just don't. Like, it has no real effect on my life, I guess. I mean, it's sad. All right,
that's
like,
such a fucking cop out to be. Oh, yes. Now I remember. This
you
is
guys
gonna
do
great.
That with
yes,
like serious
yes,
issues.
Yes, dude. Like, now I. So you've been.
You were like, Flint water doesn't affect me, so I don't.
When
care.
Did he say that?
He was like, both did. You were like, oh.
What well, I never said Flint water.
I was definitely joking.
I never on this record. This is a fucking communist smear campaign.
Yeah, are you trying
I
to say I don't
Flint
care about Flint
me?
Water?
Classic well, fucking live, dude.
Here, breaking news. Shane Gillis definitely does not give a fuck about Flint water. Woo!
Well, here's the thing. It's like, you know what? I'll say, I would like to say I do care, but it's like, I knew a lot of people were sending water to them, and I was like, well, that's nice of them. And then I kind of like go about my day.
Yeah.
Then where do? Just send a fucking case of water to Flint? You're like, yeah, someone will drink it. Just like drop it off at the post office.
I liked Flint a long time before you did, James.
I didn't mean them.
What
like
do you know about the Flintstones at Michigan like... State? What do you know about the Flintstones at Michigan State?
The idea
Mateen
that,
Cleaves,
like,
dog. Or
that's
wait.
Something that could
what,
easily
affect. Wait, so what were you about? You just had something about the cook up on the Shul Dog.
Shul Dog. Have you peeped Mishuli's Instagram lately?
No, what is it? It's Hammer and Sickle?
He had a picture, pretty much. He had a picture, was it last week? A few days ago of Gulag Archipelago. And he said,
Jordan
Peterson, you're a fucking retard.
You called him a faggot,
You
actually.
Called him a faggot. You typed out on social media, faggot.
You're such a...
Well, I want to be clear that I don't play. I don't... That way people can't be like, you so, like, liberal. Because I'm like, oh, no, I'll still... You know,
yeah, you're an edgy liberal.
You're an edgelord, dude.
You're a Chapo Trap House edgy liberal.
You're a left-leaning edgelord, dude.
Yeah, are you Dairy Queen? Anyway.
What's your problem with Jordan Peterson?
That's what I wanted. Yes.
He doesn't really say anything. Like, and then it's like, I mean, it's just self-help bullshit, kind of. And like, I've been there, you know.
What? Been where?
Oh, well, it's easy to like read that like self-help bullshit stuff and be like, oh yeah, this is like, you know, is... the way
how much
like,
of his stuff have you watched? Are you talking just about his book?
No, I've like watched his videos.
Which one?
Like this was probably like a couple years ago when he was just I guess like a year or two ago maybe.
Like what it was he has like three classes up. Which one did you watch?
Just like listening.
Maps of Meaning?
I don't know. I listened to him on like Rogan's podcast and like Duncan Trussell's podcast and like maybe a couple other ones.
So you've listened to hours and hours of Jordan Peterson.
I guess a few
and you've
hours,
yeah. You've deduced that he is in fact a faggot.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Okay. Now, Matthew, you've watched the same exact content as James here.
I don't know.
And you've deduced, in fact, that he is not a faggot.
I've deduced he's not a faggot, dude.
And James,
well, I've watched Maps of Meaning is like it was a course he taught in Harvard that was like reviewed over and over. Like this course changed my life.
But I thought we didn't like the colleges because they're like indoctrination centers.
They are,
like
but when you got one guy bucking the system and everyone's like, this is fucking great.
I mean,
I'm not against higher education.
Yeah, I don't like...
you're playing identity politics.
I don't like Hannah Gadsby's stand-up. That doesn't mean I have to hate Bill Burr's.
True that.
Yeah, but I mean, just to be like, well, it's Harvard, but it's like these people hate Harvard. You know what I mean? That's you would be like... Oh,
who?
I do hear what you're saying.
I know what you're saying, but I'm saying like when people they looked at the titles of his chapter and they went, "Oh, this is just self-help." Yeah, he even said like I wrote more like a book that everyone can. A lot of great psychologists like they have their headier works, their more esoteric stuff, and then they release stuff for the masses. That was more for the masses. If you watch Maps of Meaning, it's pretty fucking involved, and it's not self-help, really.
But, like,
it's like an exploration into, like, reality, you know, the society and everything. It's not like, stand on your 2 feet and give it the best.
Yeah, but
it's crazy,
I mean,
that people do that.
What is his, like, what is he, that the cultural Marxists are, like,
that's just like, that's something.
Well, this is a cultural Marxist.
Exactly.
You are a Marxist, right? Do you like Karl Marx?
I've never finished that book.
Then why do you have Stalin's mustache?
Yeah, why do you have Stalin's mustache, dude? You shaved that just for this episode.
You look like a young Stalin, dude. You really do look like young Stalin.
This is my beef with this whole thing. His stuff, I love Mascioli, too.
Yeah,
dude.
I love Mascioli.
I love Mascioli.
No, of course. I'm just saying he's a little...
Yeah.
Just relax.
Dude, my... I just like... His whole message is that the highest form of what a society should look for is individual expression. You know what I mean? That's like all he's saying. He's not saying like culturally. He's saying it's bad that we're preaching against that in terms of like identity politics. And that has infiltrated colleges, especially he's there being like, what the fuck?
Yeah, that's one thing I never got, because you definitely have to agree. You seem to agree with him on identity
politics.
You've
been
ousted
with this stuff.
I thought he was against individuality, and it's like...
No.
That's the only thing he talks about.
But it's like, isn't he all against fucking like... I don't even know, because it's like, you know,
he's a classic British liberal, dude.
The idea that like we have to work towards something and everyone can't be out just like doing what, like he seems like a guy who would be like, you know, like kids these days, they're just like partying and stuff. And like
if you absorb your information about him through, you know,
well, I mean,
if you're looking
smudged
glass for sure. His whole thing is that.
But well, then what does that even mean? Like, sure, go be an individual. I don't. What's like stopping and I mean now it's like
when I'm just like an evil white man is when you know what I mean, that's not an individual.
He's working for a you know, right-wing conservative think tank. It's
who
like,
else would hire him?
But I mean that's like the way those videos.
I mean I'm on a fucking pretty alt-right media network. Yeah. Compound Media is pretty fucking alt-right.
Well, I mean,
and
that's not
like,
even
who else is gonna pay me, so of course I'm gonna fucking do that.
But it's like the way PragerU is like presented makes it seem like it's not that it's not just paid propaganda for that. Like it's all these like newer like we're like CRN TV and shit. It's just like I've seen stories on there where it's like I know for a fact that is not true. I could show, you know what I mean? Or
yeah.
Like this clearly has a slant. Stuff like that.
Well, sure. Yeah, no, that's pretty
and, like, it's weird that, like, those... Because going back a little bit, those videos used to pop up as ads. I don't know if they still do, like, before certain YouTube videos. Like, there's that older woman that's, like... She's like, oh, I'm a first-wave feminist or whatever, and she, like...
Camille Paglia.
Is that her? She was, like... Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's, like... And I noticed that, like, people who, like, kind of had a... Wouldn't really like complain about feminism, but we're just like, oh, well, this lady's saying what I think, and they just kind of like latched on to people like that. And just like, yeah, I mean, they're
so I'm trying to so people latched on because like you're saying PragerU latched on to the first wave feminist.
No, like people who like
I gotta be honest, I have no fucking clue what either of you guys are talking about. I think I speak for the listener right now. What
rough.
The fuck are you two going on about?
I mean, I'm just trying to make sense.
I basically let the two dogs out in the bad dog
you
park.
Did, dude.
I put the two
took,
bad dogs to
the two
bad dog park.
Dogs you know,
and I was
dude.
Like, yo, you hate Jordan Peterson, right? And I was just like, yes.
I'm winning the fucking bunker.
You
debate,
definitely
dude.
Fucking crush this.
Yes.
Well, I will say you would definitely crush Shuldog in a debate.
Possibly. If you, I mean,
Shuldog's. Shuldog's not a great public speaker.
I'm not exactly bringing the lights out, but I have watched a lot of his stuff, and I just when people go against when they're like, it's exactly what you're saying. It's the classic fucking the
it's
year
Marxist.
2018.
He's a fucking neo-Marxist.
Well, I mean, it's a standstill. It's like people are like, yeah, but like you're taking your information through one thing, and then they're saying stuff about Jordan Peterson that I've watched like his actual classes he's recorded, and I'm like, this is not at all what this dude's about. You watch his classes, you're like, oh, this, you know. This guy's about the individual.
I also think that doesn't have, like, what's his thoughts on, like, a right-to-work state? Like, and then explain to me why you think a right-to-work state is good. Like,
what is
why
that? I don't know what that is.
I don't know. It's harder for unions to, like,
You love unions.
Yes.
You like
and
unions?
And I think, I mean, they've definitely had some bad times, certainly, but...
like now?
Well, like
now that they're obsolete and not needed in America?
Well, I meant when, like, you know, they were run by the mob and shit.
Dude,
like,
they're just fucking... Have you ever worked at a union?
No.
They're horrible, dude. I used to be a union laborer. They don't do fucking shit. You got to pay someone $400 a day with all their packages to sweep a floor. And then, like, when I got married... The first time. When I got married, I had to go, like, look at, like, these venues. And they'd be like, well, you have to have a union plumber on standby and a union electrician literally to turn the water off and turn the lights on. $800 for each of those guys. It's fucking retarded. It makes no sense.
I mean, there's definitely bad aspects like that. But it's weird how, like, I don't know. They're good for
they're good,
a reason.
For sure.
You know
people
what I mean?
Are getting, like, trapped in building fires in Chicago and, like... sweatshops, obviously, like, yeah, because if you know, sweatshops are what would exist, but and now I think we can kind of get away from them.
Well,
no one's gonna work in like a
the
little...
actual the average wage. It's this was like the first year it went down again, like it was starting to go back up, and that's what it's like. I forget what it's called exactly, but that's what it's actually worth. Mm-hmm. So, like, U.S. workers right now are in like the worst position they've been since, like...
You think it's because of non-unions or because
60s,
of illegal immigration?
I think it's a mixture of things. Sick. But, I mean, I think it's important to have, you know, just someone to, like, work.
You love the workers.
I don't think Jordan Peterson's against unions, though, dude.
But, I mean, these guys don't care about those types of issues. Like, he's
How
just...
How do you figure?
Because, I mean, this whole, like... You're just playing identity politics from the right. You know what I mean? It's like you're not like, I don't trust anyone on the right to actually stand up for the issues that I care about when the time comes. And I mean the left too. I mean Kennedy, before he left, he voted for Janus. So I mean, and that was a pretty big, you know.
What's Janus?
It was the thing for. It was about. It was like a free speech and like union type of like
the right to blow up inflatable rats.
Yeah, it's kind of like, you know, they were saying it's like I believe it was like not protected by free speech for unions to like reach out to workers that they work with and shit.
Yo, unions are fucking gay.
Look at you started, Shane.
I know.
How about this, dude?
This is going to be awful.
This is going to be sick, dude. No, this is good stuff, dude.
There's a lot of guys.
Let's drop the politics, dude.
There's a lot of
talk
union,
as humans.
There's a lot of union listeners that are going to be very excited to hear them finally get some representation. We as the workers are like, we're like tired of like you guys not paying us. So we're like not going to work so until you like... You gotta, like, pay us more now.
Like, I think you'll hear a lot, like, there's this meme that goes out around Labor Day about how, like, capitalism was what got workers' rights and shit. But, like, I'm reading that book about Prohibition, and, like, Ford voted for Prohibition because he thought workers didn't have the right to drink on their day off. You know what I mean? Like, talk about... anti-fucking...
Yeah, that's the guy who sold... We were just talking about that. That's the guy who sold fucking shit to Nazis.
He liked the Nazis.
He was a Nazi. He was a fucking Nazi.
Yeah,
totally.
Yeah.
Ford does not represent the people at all.
But Ford also, like, did a lot of good. So, like, he also had some bad aspects.
That was funny. I actually went for a job interview one time when I was in college, and the guy was like, all right, everything's looking good. He's like, do you drink on the weekend? And I was like... I was like, fucking... 21. I was getting hammered every day, and I was just like, yeah, you know, sometimes. He's like, I don't want someone hungover in my office. And I was like, okay.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, so this guy was, and this was like for a bullshit internship, and I remember being like, what a fucking dick.
He's trying to get you on that Model T assembly
Ford,
line.
Ford, yeah. So he's trying to get me to sell fucking tanks to the Nazis, dude.
He was.
Well, it is a weird thing, and like, I admit, like, I'm full of a lot of contradictions. It's even like with weed, it's like, I do also kind of think an employer has the right to be like, I don't want someone stoned in my office.
Yeah, time. Definitely, dude.
As
yeah.
much
sure.
as I'm like...
As often as you're stoned in offices. You're stoned in offices every day of the week.
You're trapped in like an Inception mirror hallway. We're like, wait, can I be stoned in an office?
How often would you say you're stoned in an office? For real.
Probably
5 days a week.
Yeah. Well, that is true, because as someone who loves weed too, it's like, I get people are like... it saddens me that, like, you know, if you work certain jobs, you know, people have like government jobs, you can't smoke weed or whatever. Yeah. But it's also like, I don't know, man. You should be able to have the shit in your system. But if you're like so high to the point where someone's like, dude, are you fucking high? It's like, you should just get fired for that. If you're doing everything normal and someone drug tests you and like, oh, you have weed in your system? It's like, yeah, it's in there. I was at the beach last weekend.
And also, it's when you sign up for the job, they tell you.
Yeah, a lot of recruiters are letting it go now, though. I know, my friend's girlfriend's a recruiter, and they're like, you got to take a drug test, but this company doesn't care about weed. And they're just like, sick. Whatever. Yeah, it's pretty tight.
It's a chill fucking company.
But you can't really, like, I would love to get an office job and just go high to an office job every day and just be like, and just chill.
Oh, that would, dude, if I got high. Actually,
you know what? I say this, and I've done it, and it's hell.
It's
got to
be the worst thing. Dude, if I got high at an office job and just sat there, I'd be like, this is my fucking life. This is my life. I'm going to die in here.
I told you I got high and went to go cold call, and I was in there just like, the guy was like, hey, we're going to be listening into your calls. And I was like, really? I would cold call. The thing, phone would ring, a big ding, ring, ring. Answer machine, I'm like, yes, next number. Like, I did not want to talk to anyone.
Oh, dude. I got high at Skankfest.
Yeah.
And they were like, Ari Shaffir's late. I was sitting with Soder, and this lady comes running over to Soder, and she's like, Ari, we can't find Ari Shaffir. Can you headline? Yeah. And he was like, I'm too fucking high. Shane will. And I just smoked with him. And I, you know me, I can't, if I get high at all, I'm like, so Soder was like, Shane will do it. And I was like, dude, they don't want to fucking see me headline. They're down there waiting for Ari Shaffir. I'm not going to go fucking close the show. And he was like, come on, dude.
Yeah, just do it.
And she
faith.
Looked at me and was like, do you want to? I was like, yeah, I guess. So like, I go down there. It's like, it was in the Creek in the Cave's basement. So there's like six dudes just sadly sitting on a couch. I was like, dude, if I go up there. And Skankfest was funny because it was literally just a bunch of me's walking around.
Yeah.
Like, it was just, like, fat white dudes. Like,
holy fuck.
So, like, there's nothing I can do to offend or shock or anything like that with comedy.
They probably would like you.
They would like me for sure, but it's like, and they do like me.
Yeah.
But it's also, like, in my head before I go on stage, I'm like, what the fuck am I going to say to these guys?
Yeah.
Like, am I going to, normally I kind of need a liberal audience.
Yeah.
To be like, you know, you guys are fucking gay, right?
You do pretty good, though, in
okay, I'll do good in an alt-right room.
You go to fucking, like, Harrisburg and shit, you fucking
Well, that's a
up.
Different form of conservative, because they can get offended. True. They're the type of conservatives that are like, did he just say dick sucking?
Yeah, that's true.
You don't
yeah.
say that around here. So you can offend them. If you're talking to a bunch of 4chan dudes sitting in a basement, you need to be like... You would crush if you went up there and you were like, you know, the Clintons are on the fucking Epstein Express. They'd all be like, oh, Shoe Dog, you should get in there. There's a lot of Cumtown fans. They'd be like, we're also fucking
at Skankfest, dude. I fucking bombed it. Creek in the first time I ever went, and like
everybody bombs a Creek in the Cave. Yeah. I'm a real New Yorker now. Go ahead.
I had a little bit too much to drink because I was supposed to do that show.
You? You got too fucked up to perform?
Upstairs, snake oil or whatever, mm-hmm. and Six was like, oh, sign up for the open mic, like, do the open mic while you're here, and, like, I went up there thinking, like, yeah, this, and everyone just stared at me.
Yeah, because it was a bunch of it was a bunch of open mic comics in a tiny basement garage. It's a fucking...
You know Karl Marx was an alcoholic? Karl Marx, he wrote all... What was his big book he wrote?
Communist Manifesto.
Yeah, that one. He apparently was like a 26-year-old.
Look around this. Look around Shuley's office right now. I bet you can find about six copies of it.
He wrote that when he was like a 26-year-old drunk. So everyone's basing ideology off of just like a drunk 26-year-old's thoughts. Being like, yeah, this does make sense.
Shoe Dog's living his life off of some drunk fucking bitch ass.
It's fun. You definitely, I mean, from one enigma to another, dude, you're a total fucking enigma.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Because you'd think the radical left Philadelphia comedy scene would, bring you into a fucking open arms.
Yeah, but he doesn't play identity politics.
Exactly,
He's
dude.
Too radical left.
Damn,
they're
dude.
All based, they're all based on identity politics.
Yeah.
Like, by being like, Jeremy Piven should not be allowed to perform here. Yeah. The fucking media in Philadelphia is like, and we're live with an open micer who's done stand-up for 1 year. What do you think about this comedy club's booking technique? Shuley, on the other
Dude,
hand,
one is... like, well, they don't book me a lot, which is annoying, but
they
like...
They all do that. Every yeah. single one of them is like, well, yeah, they don't book me because I'm a woman. It's like, dude, they're doing all-female showcases.
Yeah, man.
And after 2 months, they ran out of comics.
Yes.
They have the same fucking 8 ladies go up every month and just rotate who headlines.
Yeah, for sure.
Anyway, I'm not even involved in this. I shouldn't be. I'm in New York now.
Exactly. I mean, you're looking down from the mountains.
I'm up on the fucking, I'm up in my kingdom. I'm hearing word of this. A raven landed in Philadelphia and they're like, yeah, a bunch of dorks are fucking complaining about Punchline.
What's the thing, Michelle? You're a nice fucking dude. Always helps me out whenever I'm like, yo, I have a question with this, question with that. I know you set up other local comedy theater sound systems too. They've kind of given you the boot.
Really?
Yeah, man. Michelle would give the shirt off his back.
He really would.
Well, if he's a comedy, he has to. He's a true communist, dude. Yeah. But
well, I think it's like because you guys are like funnier, so it was like they couldn't really do anything. And because it was almost like that same like thread, I think it was, where like that chick tried to go after you and like no one was into it. And then she was like,
oh, yeah.
Mishuli. And they were like, all right, dude, hit the bricks.
Dude, that is true. When the Blackster dude tried to come at me.
Oh, yeah.
And bees.
Yeah.
Yeah, some lady tried in the Philadelphia community.
She was not an African American. That's just her last name.
Well, you know, we got an argument.
Go to the Blackster.
Yeah, well, like, yeah, sorry.
That's not a black lady.
Her last name is Black. Well, whatever. And she came at me on Facebook.
Yeah, for stalking her.
No, you know what the original argument was?
Because Matt was stalking her, by the way, for
why,
the record.
Dude?
Well, you stalked that
you
lady.
You know what I like, dude.
You stalked
you
that lady.
You know what I like.
I know you love short-haired, pale, white chicks.
No, I don't. That's the
yeah,
thing.
You do. That's why you stalked
no,
her.
No, dude.
All right, for the record, all the time, when me and Matt would lay together in bed at night, Matt would be like, you know what I need? I'd be like, what, bro? He'd be like, just a short-haired, extreme feminist, pale white lady that does nothing but complain on the internet. I was like, fuck yeah.
I found one, dude.
And
she
he was like, oh,
know.
I found one. And then he looked at her website for... I woke up the next morning and he was still searching her Instagram.
Yeah.
You stalked her hard.
Wow, look at all these long Instagram posts next to pictures with all caps. This is so hot, dude.
Oh my God, so hot.
You know what we started arguing about? She was trying to say that... about writing and cultural appropriation. She was like, well, if a white writer writes... they can't write in a black character, it's appropriation. Like, how would a white guy know what a black woman's hair is like in the ocean? Which I was like, maybe he's fucking touched a black chick's hair while she's in the ocean. Fuck you, McCusker, you're the worst kind. You're literally a piece of shit. Fuck you, I hope you die, you scum. And I'm like, what the fuck is your problem? And then one time I fucking retweeted her and I was like, ha 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 ha. Because it was some stupid shit. And then she called me a stalker and fucking, you know, in my little community of comedians, and I just put up, dude, all the screenshots. Like, here's all my interactions in 2 years with this chick. There's been four of them. Two she instigated. I did make fun of her Twitter. My bad. and then everyone was kind of like, and that's the thing, too. It is true that I definitely used my power, dude. I was a Helium host at the time.
You were a Helium host.
So, which
host.
Is basically like a congressman in the Philadelphia fucking
yeah,
comedy
true.
Scene. So people were like, well, I might be able to use him for...
True. As a host at Helium.
They saw Shules, dude. The humble samurai, dude. They're like, oh, get him there.
Just a humble worker. Just a man of the people.
He said faggot on Facebook. Let's kick him out of everything forever.
It'll make us look good if we kick someone out. For real, that's how they operate.
Yeah.
And
human
obviously,
sacrifice.
And without, because again, I know the people that are doing this. I like most of them with the Jeremy Piven thing. I do get along with them when I see
fine.
Them. They're all great people.
They're fine.
Great people. Some of the best people. But when you, it's like, this is clearly giving them, now they're in Philly Mag, they're in all these fucking publications for speaking out against Jeremy Piven performing.
Yeah.
Because he was accused of sexual assault.
Yeah.
Did he ever get found guilty of anything?
I don't believe so. I mean, I don't even know if.
But also, it's like, here's how you're getting power.
I know.
It's like, if you point out this, then you'll get interviewed in the news.
Yeah.
And it's like, you literally haven't been doing stand-up long enough to be remotely good at it.
Yep.
And here you are getting, you know,
well,
publication.
Everyone makes fun of your girl who just did a special. Like, I've been doing stand-up for 10 years.
She's Hannah Gadsby? Yeah. She's like, oh, I'm pretty good at this thing. Oh, I've been doing it for about 10 years
yeah,
now.
Yeah, everyone makes fun of her for that.
So you've been doing stand-up for 10 years? Oh, shit. You're a fucking master.
Yeah, dude.
Anyway.
But yeah, that is funny, man.
It's a stupid
Jeremy
thing,
Piven, man. He's going to come to Philly when he sees all the fucking outrage against his show, just be on his balcony at the end of the night overlooking the city and be like, I hate this town.
Yeah, well, he's got.
Oh, yeah.
He's got.
Oh, yeah.
He's got four open micers hot on his trail.
I want to see Communist Entourage, dude. Where, like, everyone in the squad does Contourage? Just as well. Yeah, Contourage, dude.
Yeah.
They just go, and everyone does just as... It's just like chicks with buzz cuts being like, yeah, I can play in today. I have a new TV show. And the other fat chick's like, I love this town. And they're all wearing the same gray uniforms, dude. It'd be tight.
Hell yeah.
Well, it's actually weird because like...
Oh, yeah.
For just like...
Me too. Me too.
as like quote unquote like left as these people are, they're really like establishment Democrat, and it's
like Clinton's.
Yeah, like that. Like, I mean, I don't vote, but like,
you were quoted saying Obama's a Clinton in blackface. Is that true? Damn,
you said that?
No, that's fuck. Who's that one guy? Cornel West said that.
Oh,
I was just fucking with you.
I was gonna say, God damn,
Schultz. Cornel West said that about Obama.
Anyway, I know you were trying to talk for the first time in 10 minutes, and I've been doing all I've been doing all the fucking talking, and I apologize, but we should shut the fuck up about the fucking. Never mind, because then you got banned. We should talk about you getting
shadow banned, dude.
The fucking the liberal.
That is something interesting about you. But you're saying they're not real. They're not real.
Well, yeah, it's
leftists.
Like, yeah, yeah. I mean, they do like the identity politics shit, but it's like they love to like I don't know. They just want people fired and like fined and like as much as they'll be like I'm anti-jail, and then they're like we need a law to stop people from spreading their legs too far. And it's like, who do you think that's going to affect first? And like, they're
black guys with huge dongs.
It was like the
cross my fucking legs, dude.
If you want a law against unruly actions on the subway, the 13th Amendment's going to be in full effect, dude. We are going to be business will be a booming in the private prison sector. If you're as somebody who lives in New York now, I took the fucking megabus yesterday. If there were laws against unruly behavior, about 6 African Americans would be going to jail right now.
You think they'd be in there?
I got on the megabus. Things were going great.
Yeah.
Black dude to my left starts throwing up into a plastic bag. He started puking into a plastic bag. Dude, I almost cried. I want to go home.
Dude, you started crying next to him. There's some other dude that's like, I got a fucking guy throwing up in a plastic bag. Some other dude's crying.
That retarded guy's sobbing.
Dude, I was in.
Though. This is because then the guy in front of me, his seat was back, and I was in the seat behind him to the right. So I could see his Facebook, or I could see what he was doing on his phone.
Oh, so he's in front of you, leaning back.
He was leaning back.
Yeah.
He was a black dude on a fucking public transit. Of course, if you're black and you have the option to recline your seat, you immediately recline your seat. You're like, this is my space.
He smashed a lever.
Yeah, he smashed that lever. But then I was looking at his fucking phone, and he was a gay dude just watching dudes jerk off.
Stop.
Yeah, for real. Almost the entire bus trip, he was watching different people on Twitter. It was all people's Twitter feeds. Gay, like black gay Twitter of dudes jerking off. That's like literally up. Dick in the camera, fucking just stroking their dick.
And you were...
And that was in front of me. And then to the left of me, black dudes puking into a plastic bag. I was just sitting there just...
That's fucking hilarious.
Trying to listen to fucking...
You should have smacked Carlin's, him like, nice.
Carlin's new fucking Japan... What hardcore that? History. He's got new hardcore history.
I heard about that,
About Japan. You'd love it.
And again. Again, imagine these bombs come down. Everyone you know.
And imagine. this is medieval Japan.
It's about samurais?
Well, it starts out, he gives a brief history of Japan.
I love samurais.
It's such a good, dude, Japan
is... That's what I am politically, dude, a samurai. You should just be able to dominate a thing of land, make people make rice for you. If they disobey, you fucking... cut their motherfucking head off. Someone cuts your head off, too bad.
There's a sick story that... Did you listen to it at all, Shuldog?
No.
So it opens with this dude in the Philippines that gave up. He finally surrendered World War II in like 73,
mm-hmm.
1974. He was in the jungle. They put him in the jungle to be like a disruptor in the Philippines, just to be like...
Who put him there?
The Japanese.
Oh, yeah.
They're like, just fuck shit up on this island as long as you can. They would just put guys out there.
Yeah.
So him and two other guys were stationed just in the jungle on this Philippines island.
Yeah.
And they never got word to stop. So they kept doing it into the 70s.
What were
they did
doing?
It for 30 years.
Fucking shit
they were
up.
Murdering people. They would kill people on the island. They killed
just
like 30
creating
people.
Creating terror.
Yeah. Just setting bombs off, fucking
what
shit up
fuck?
On the island. And the search parties, because he was like an urban legend at this point. They're like, don't go into that fucking section of the woods. There's a Japanese dude that will kill you. This is in 1970. And so they would leave newspaper clippings for him and be like, dude, the war's over. Like, you can come out.
Chill.
You can come out. And he said that he thought this was fake. He thought they were all fake. He thought they were fake news.
Was that fake news in him?
Because he was like, Japan would never surrender.
He's like, all fake news.
Yeah, he's like, all fake news. Japan will never surrender. And he was, and Carlin's like, and he was right. Japan would never surrender. Not like this. And again. So Japan became pussies. They got fucking what for'd. They got two nukes, knocked him into line real quick. Oh. So he was like, we would never be fucking listening to rock and roll and fucking blue jeans and all shit. He's like, this is fake. Japan had to find his former officer, who owned a bookstore in Japan at this point, and fly him.
It's Japanese Rambo, bro.
Yeah, they had to fly him to the outskirts of the jungle.
It's Rambo.
And be like, yeah, it is Rambo. He's like, no, Rambo, you can come out of the woods now. That's the Japanese Carlin. And again. So this guy was fighting World War II into the 70s by himself. Holy and like when shit. They found him, they found a stash of like grenades, and he had like several thousand rounds of ammunition.
Holy shit. He was ready to go. Man. I didn't know that. It's
great
crazy.
Story. And then they just, I think it was legal. I think when he came out of the woods, they were like, you're not in trouble.
It was just war.
Like, you were still going. Anyway, so that's out. Hilarious. George, I always call him George Carlin.
Yeah.
Dan Carlin's got that out right now.
I thought you were watching. Sick. When you said George, I thought you were just watching like the hippy dippy weatherman on the bus. And I was like, what the fuck?
No, I was listening to Dan Carlin just be like, hit again.
Dude, I was in Domino's last night. You ever go to Domino's like 11 p.m.?
There's a lot of Japanese
popping.
In there.
No, there's zero. Japanese there's are in there. Zero Japanese.
I don't say Domino's.
No, dude, I went in there yesterday.
All right, not the Domino's. A best of pizza.
I'm still laughing about Rambo.
Rambo, your bread.
Oh, you got first bird.
Your first bread. Your bread reign is over. Rambo, come out from her jungle. He walked out. I was like, officer, what? Is it?
I was at Domino's last night. I got the urge. I was driving home. I was fucking driving home, and I was like, they have gluten-free pizza, dude. As you know, dude.
Oh, yeah, you hit
I'm
that.
I'm a good boy, dude, but I have a Chad. I have a disease that makes me eat a Chad diet.
Yes.
So I'm driving home, and I've just been, like, eating pretty good. I'm like, I need some fucking pizza, dude. So I'm like, I call Domino's, I order. I'm like, so sick they're open late. I roll into Domino's thinking, like, no, I'm like, it's fucking 11:30. No one's going to be in there. Fucking mob, dude. Just mobbed. It's me, an Indian chick, and it's like four or five black dudes. And I roll in there. The one black dude comes into Domino's watching a video of himself. Because I peeked at his phone, too. Like, what the fuck's this guy doing? He's just watching a video of himself talking as he walked. It was like the weirdest thing to see. I was like, what the fuck? Watching a video of himself, like, ha-ha. And then he goes and sits down and showing this other guy.
Actually exactly what I do.
Yeah, dude,
I listen
so
to the
fucking,
podcast. I listen to
exactly. I do it and walk around, but he's had a video of himself, and I looked at him, looked at the screen. I'm like, well, it was just weird.
Maybe he had a self-help video on how to get to Domino's. Such a fear of it that he had to record himself, like, you can do this, dude.
You can do this, bro. No, it was him, like, and what the fuck? It was just him, and he's like, I had to laugh, and he shows his boy. And I'm like, it was funny. It's a crowd is fucking there. Then this other guy walks in, this other black dude rolls in there. He goes, just fucking walks in front of me, and there was like all the other black dudes in there. And he was like, you guys got any deals going on? And the lady at the front...
Yeah, it's fucking Domino's.
The lady at the front's like, yeah, well, we have...
$3 pizza.
We have two... They're like, we have a special, like, one large, one medium. And how much? And he was like, 18, whatever it was, 18 bucks. He goes, that's not going to work for me. What else you got? And she was like, that's our deal we're doing right now. And he was like, what about if I get, like, two mediums and a large? And she was like, yeah, well, you know, larges are $9.99, mediums are this. He's like, come on, man. He starts haggling. She's like, sir, I don't set the prices. And he sat there and, like, negotiated, like, a package.
He haggled a Domino's at 11 p.m.?
He haggled a package, like, that was acceptable to him. He's like, I'm going to buy wings, too. I'm going to buy wings. I'm going to buy maybe three pizzas. The cashier was, like, a 19-year-old Puerto Rican chick. She's like, I don't know, man. I don't care. I don't know what to do. The two dudes who walked in were like looking at their phones, looked at him and were like, what the fuck? And they looked at me and I started laughing. Like, and then everyone, they like, we laughed and I saw them kind of look down like, is he fucking laughing at? They kind of looked kind of pissed.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my God. I have a white friend who does that, man. He'll walk into like Wawa. I'm like, yo, how much is it for like Wawa, a pack of cigarettes? And they're like, $8.64. And he's like, come on, man.
Help me out.
Come on, man. That damn, man. Are you serious? It's like, will you just fucking buy them?
I think
leave?
I know the white friend that would do that.
Bert, for sure. It's Bert. How much for this? And they're like, he's like, God damn, man.
You may remember Bert from our prison episode.
I'm trying to get him back.
So, Shuldog.
Shulies, baby.
I do love the haggling with a clearly a minimum wage employee.
Or haggling with a chain.
Being like, yeah, haggling with a chain because you're talking to somebody that's like, dude, I don't care. The wings are already made.
Yeah, dude.
Like, you're not hooking me up by giving this company business.
I'm not going to get, like, a commission off this deal. He's like, well, that's not going to work for me.
What if I toss in six wings? Can we call it a deal?
It was the art of the meal, dude.
It was the art of the meal. It was Dontell Trump.
Art of the meal.
Done by like, Darnell Trump.
He was like, all right, what if I get, like, what if I had 12 wings to the order, a set of cheese and bread? She was like, sir, I don't make the prices.
He's like, she does make the prices. She's just trying to stonewall me.
Yeah, pretty much, dude. He had the art of the meal on her, dude. She just stonewalled him.
So, Shul Dog, what's up, dog?
You know, just I'm actually living in your old room now.
Oh yeah, you moved into the basement. What do you think of that?
It's scarier than I thought it was gonna
be. It's a little creepy down there. It gets a little spooky.
I was in a customer's house. I was painting a big house. I was the last one down the basement. Had to shut the lights off. Dude, I fucking ran up the stairs. I'm literally, it's middle of the day. I was in the third floor walking around. There was like an office and shit. And then I opened one door. I was tasked to go find like the pre-existing paint to like match it up. So I'm like wandering through almost like a man. This place is fucking big. I think a mansion's technically like 5,000 square feet. It was right around there. So I'm they had a fucking like boardroom in their house, like meetings.
Damn.
Shit. So I'm walking.
Do you
around.
Think that was Dontell Trump's house?
It was just empty Domino's. But he was just reselling Domino's to like different countries. So then I walk through this one room that goes to another room, and then I get to this other room that there's just a door with a little key in the thing, and I was like, I'm gonna go look see what's in there. I walked to the doorknob and went.
I'm not looking in there.
Just fucking ran the fuck away.
Dude, I love the idea of a board meeting, haggling, calling a Domino's, haggling. A guy on a speakerphone just like, what if we toss in 6 wings?
All right, we'll knock down 30 cents. Yeah. Dude, I told you I got free Domino's one time. It's called Domino's, and I was like, yo, man, I'm getting 2 medium pizzas, and I need that large from last week that you guys messed up on. And they were like, what? And I was like, yeah, dude, you guys told me I'd get a free pizza. And they were like, what's your name? And I was like, I gave them all my information. And they were like, who'd you speak to? And I was like, I don't know, some guy, like an ethnic sounding name. It's like West Philly, Domino's. They go, they're like.
You're like some guy with a Muslim beard. Yeah, like, Philly Domino's.
They're like, when'd you call? I was like, dude, it was last Friday, right at like 7 o'clock. And they were, I was like, you guys told me you'd give me free pizza. What the hell? And they were like, all right, let us check the records. I'm like, yeah, go ahead, look at them. I'm like, no way.
They don't have records.
Week through a fucking, and it's Friday's busy as fuck, so they don't remember. So they're like, dude, 5 minutes, they try to ice me on hold, and they call back. Like, all right, sir, we're going to bring it. You can do it once to like almost any chain pizza place.
Wow.
So this guy could have just done the.
I used to do that to Domino's too.
It's a move.
I used to call and say, I have a coupon here for free cheesy bread. Every time I ordered, I'd be like, I have a coupon for free cheesy bread. And the guy brings you the cheese bread, and you're like, they'll never ask.
They don't give a fuck.
They don't care. Yeah. Also, so back to the basement. The basement is scary. Yeah,
it is fucking spooky down there.
It's funny because I forgot it was scary. It took me a month to get over the fact that it was scary down there. I'd be like, someone's in that tiny door.
Well, I thought it was noises. Good. And then the other night, nobody was home. So usually at least 6 is like upstairs. It was just nobody was home. And I was like kind of high. And then I started thinking about being scared. And then I was like, fuck, I'm.
Now you're scared. Yeah. Now there's definitely a ghost in here. Or I would get high and get afraid of fires. Like, if there's a fire, I'm just trapped in this pit. Because there's one stairwell.
That's hilarious.
If there's a fire upstairs, you're just dead.
And, like, how loud it is, that's the next story.
When they run down the... Yeah, when the Asians fucking...
Yeah.
It's just
goes. Crouching tiger down the fucking steps.
Across the fucking room.
It's like, I mean, you guys are probably, like, two deadest... Oh, and you were downstairs, but, like, I'd be in this room at night, like, at, like... 3-4 in the morning and shit just starts like falling. And,
yeah.
Like, you hear the water behind the wall?
Yeah.
Very spooky stuff.
And you're in a fucking basement, dude. If a ghost is going to appear.
It's coming to the basement.
Yeah, dude.
And it's probably the ghost of Karl Marx showing up like, James, you did the right thing by getting banned from the open mic. You are truly a communist warrior. Thank you, comrade. But yeah, the Asians fly down the steps. That would scare me every morning. I'd be like, someone's pounding on the door.
Yeah.
Because their steps, directly underneath their steps, it's straight into the basement.
It goes...
Why the fuck do they run down the steps?
I kind of run down steps like that, too.
You do. I've seen you.
I fucking fly down steps. I'm also 195 now, too.
You're a big dog.
I'm a fucking...
You bulk. I'm fucking, good boy, dude. I fucking groped you at the fucking Starbucks.
You were at Starbucks earlier, and Shane gives me like a hug. And then he reached around, like, grabbed my ass and, like, shook it real quick.
Two hands got underneath
and it's like a family just walked by.
Family's right behind him. He's like, you got a fucking plump butt, dude.
You have to start hugging. Like, come on, give him your hug and just squeeze your ass.
Squeeze
like,
ass cheeks.
Fucking working out, bro.
Fucking nice rump.
It's such a funny... Grabbing a guy's ass is so fucking funny.
Good rumpus.
I don't know if yous were in the room that...
They got, yous.
Oh, what is it?
The guy who was wearing the suspenders at this shoot last weekend. And he was standing in the front and like... I didn't want to say it, but all I could think about was, like, Matt always talking about having a thick ass, and then, like, Rainey was just like, dude, your ass is thick as shit.
You got a thick butt.
Dude, did that shoot, you know, they had, like, that little dildo thing?
Yeah.
I was laughing. We walked downstairs, and it's, like, a bunch of dudes just holding that thing, being like, yeah, that's about what my dick looks like all the time. And I was like, shut the fuck up, dude. Yeah. You were like,
not at all.
You said about a semi. You're like, that's a nice semi. And I'm like,
that's
all right,
a thick semi.
I can get behind that. It was like four dudes I know just being like, there's obviously chicks around. And they're like, yeah, dude, that's pretty much what I'm. It was like a fucking, like, a pretty, a nice beefy.
That was like a six-inch.
Six-inch soft
probably five-inch.
Yeah, it was a
thick,
beefy.
Though.
Nothing to sneeze at. Soft boy, five-inch. I watched four fucking dudes be like, yeah, that's about what I'm. Yeah, you know, that's not. That's normal dick right there.
Yeah.
And I'm looking at them like. My bird's like a fucking inch right now,
yeah,
dude.
My bird right now is
teeny.
Is
exactly.
Fucking in. My bird's in good mode.
I got podcasting bird right now, dude.
Podcast bird is it shields you from all the Marxism. It fucking ducks in from the Marxists.
That was crazy. Then when they started they started shaving the dick to make it like, because they had to use it as a prop and blur it out, so they wanted it to be skinny, and like they started shaving it, and they were like, oh my god, that's so thin. I'm like, I want to be like, pull your fucking pants. Let's everyone
bust
their dicks
out. Let's see your
out.
Dick, dude.
Let's see you guys all hanging these dildos. You
that
guys
was a
talking.
Thick semi.
That was a nice boy, dude.
That was a thick semi.
That was something like you walk
that was
around.
Borderline boner.
That's like the most your dick can be before is a boner.
And that's when I show my dick
exactly.
to my friends. I'll just take it out and be like,
I should have, in retrospect, I should have been like, pull your dick. Let me put your dick next to that dick right now.
You should have.
There's girls there, though.
You should have told them to take out their dicks.
I should have, like, yo.
She said, take your pussy out, and you should have put it in there and been like, do you think
I accidentally
that's...
smacked a girl's ass in the film set that day.
What?
I didn't. It was an accident. I was looking at the dick, and I turned around like this, classic backhand to the butt, and I was like, my bad. Mm. She just laughed.
That's the best. When you get a free pass for a grope, an accidental grope,
it's a
nice thing.
It wasn't a grope. It was just like a...
you groped a lady on them set.
It was a brush.
As soon as the cameras are around,
in
Matt
my head,
starts
in my head,
groping.
I was just like, oh my god, dude, this is how it all starts.
Yep.
I was like, oh yeah, me too. All
right, Shuli, so what's it like being a fucking Marxist douche?
It's tough. I'm like a pariah on the Philadelphia comedy scene. And...
Well, I never knew. They didn't really pariah you for Marxism. They more pariahed you for like what? They weren't like, but Shuli, your Marxism's out of control. We don't want to share our proceeds of $5 tickets.
No, it was just, I'm too much of a free speech boy, and they couldn't handle that, you know?
Heard that, bro. You,
well, basically, by free speech, he means he would get
on
Facebook
acid.
And be like, yo, women fucking suck at stand-up.
Yeah, free speech is a right to be on acid for 3 days and be like, fuck, girl, comedians, the Philadelphia comedy community. Which, hey, that is your right.
Exactly.
But in your defense... Women do suck at stand. No, in your defense, there is a lot. There's a ton of shit, and we've covered this a fucking million times. But it's like if you're a female comic in Philly, if you do stand up for less than a year, you're already on every showcase. You're on every single thing possible, and everybody's doing that fake laugh we talked about on the first episode, where it was like, ha 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 ha.
Until the rubber
no matter
meets
what
the road,
you say.
Man. Sometimes you see the rubber meets the road at a real show, and
then you get on a real show,
man. Yeah,
a real show.
Yeah,
and now it's like
I think it's not just comedy. Like,
also congratulations, Cassandra D, for winning Philly's Funniest.
True that, dude.
She's very funny.
She is good,
undeniably great.
I think there's this weird thing with like any type of like passion or whatever, like
passion,
painting or like you know music or like there's and maybe it's always been this way, but it feels like there's just so much. Everyone's like, hey, you're great, and like that, like what you. Just trying is great, and you're like, no, like you have to like differentiate. You know what, like
you sound like Jordan Peterson.
True that. Well, you don't believe in chaos magic. I was thinking about that this on the way over. Chaos magic's basically the secret, where there's like no such thing as truth, and if you just believe things, that's what makes things come to exist. Because I was thinking about that, I'm like, I love chaos magic, but then there's people who are like,
what the fuck are you talking about?
It's chaos magic, bro. But then there's people who are like, well, I'm a writer, and it's like, dude, you suck.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really work for everyone. I'm sorry. I don't know what... I don't know. That kind of was connected to your
I feel point. Like that would, like... Because, like, I play music and shit, too, and just, like, I don't know. I feel like there's no one being like, you should think about, you know, releasing that album or type of, you know, like there's just,
I hear you. There's a lot of trash. Dude.
I think especially with the internet where it's so easy to put stuff out that like people aren't as quick to think like, is this what I want as like a representation of,
it's like the hour I did at Helium. Yeah. I don't want to release that. It wasn't the best I could do. That.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a good set for people there, but I listened to just the audio of it and it is not that funny.
Well, it's your Joe material, you know what I mean?
Sure. But I didn't...
I mean, you've heard all this. You're not going to listen back and be like, oh my God.
Listened to that hour and I was like, fuck. Because you can just hear the mic. The crowd wasn't as pronounced. Just in the early version of the audio you sent me. And it's like me like...
Oh, you're hearing... You get real weird about hearing your
You
breathing.
Can hear that fucking like... You know that noise you make? Where everybody does it. Like, I usually do it when I'm like looking at my phone like late at night or something. You just hear yourself like... Like you don't make that noise. That? You make that noise. Sure everyone
do.
Does.
Yeah, I'm sure I do.
Anyway,
no, I
did that in the mic, like because I'd be smiling or laughing with the crowd. I'd be like,
I know what you're talking about. Well, there's the that was the thing too when people were like, "Fuck yeah, dude, the gatekeepers are dead. Now we can release anything." And now I'm on Spotify, listen to my like Spotify recommended weekly. Like, dude, I just listened. I got 20 songs recommended to me. I fucking couldn't listen to like 10 seconds of any of them. Horrible.
Yeah.
Horrible.
Sorry.
Dude, that is true. There's a bunch of crap out now, which kind of sucks. But I still like it. I still like being able to put out the content.
You just did it. Shul Dog.
Yes.
So, what do you think, dude? What do you think about what's going on?
How are you going to stage your comeback, bro?
How are you going to come back to the Philly comedy scene?
I actually just started having fun again. And, like I finally had... Because I was, like, doing, like, the same 7 to 10, whatever, like, and I was just, like, not being able to get out enough, and it was just, like, the mics I would get to, it's, like, the scene's kind of dying, I think, in a lot of...
You think the Philly comedy scene's dying?
Yeah.
That's how bubbles burst, dude. They start at the lowest level.
True that.
Comedy bubbles bursting.
The Philadelphia comedy scene is pretty tough right now.
Also,
people ruined it.
I don't think that's a good thing where it's like, if we're all just like being like, hey, that's great. It's like, how are you supposed to get better to, you know what I mean? Cause it's like, if no one around you is like pushing themselves, then it's like, I think that pushes you to push yourself in ways.
Yeah. It was like, did you go to the Raven, the old school Raven, when like, it was like the first second half was like a delineated thing to where like, if you didn't get on the first half, it was everyone being like, you're not that good yet. Try harder.
I'd
get back.
At like the very end, like when I first started coming around, was like when that was ending.
I did it. I was like, that's how I came up. And it was like, I can't wait to get on the first half. This is going to be awesome. But like, it just was on laughs. If you crushed, they'd put you on. And then it was nothing. It was nothing like, well, this is very unfair. If you said that, they'd be like, get the fuck, dude. But beat it, dude. So yeah, it's the death, dude. It's well, it'll come back.
It'll come back.
You'll be the phoenix that rises from the ashes, dude.
That's the one thing that I am kind of excited about is the fucking comedy bubble to burst. Because, man, those Netflix specials just continue to stink.
And it will, because people are going to go, man, stand-up sucks.
Once it's like, you see fucking 30 specials and they're all the exact same, it's like, all right, shut it down. This sucks. This sucks.
Batten down the hatches.
And then the people that are doing stand-up for the wrong reasons quit.
True.
And who aren't getting laughs quit. Mm-hmm. And the people like me who are fucking excellent artists... And true fucking pros.
Yeah, man. 5 years from now, will be interesting.
Yeah, I agree.
It'll be tight to see the people still holding on. And like this, like fucking like, or honestly, I think, let's say 6 years from now, once Trump does his second term and is done, if he's out of office, what the fuck would they talk about? I mean, like, this new president's okay, I guess.
Do you guys remember Donald Trump?
Remember Donald Trump?
You remember that guy, that orange fucking racist?
Yeah.
It's like, you mean the guy who created world peace? Because that's 6 years from now.
Exactly.
Trump will have already mission accomplished.
We'll be in Trump Utopia, dude.
We will.
They'll probably be in Guantanamo. All the female comedians will be in Guantanamo by
the
end of
6 years.
They'll
be in Gitmo.
Yeah, their worst fucking
fears
will be realized.
They'll be in Fitmo, dude.
They'll be in Fitmo.
They'll be in the improv troupe. Well, James, you're a hell of an
I've been dying to have you on though.
I know.
I always say like I have Michelle on.
And I was thinking about that, and I was like, oh man, it's gonna because I'm kind of only funny on stage, like, you are occasionally on Facebook.
You're a funny
like,
bull,
the first time I saw you do stand-up, I was like, holy shit, James is actually funny. Because I'd hung out with you a couple of times, and I'm like, this guy, what is this guy, a fucking mute? Is this guy fucked up? Like, is he fucked up?
And I don't really, and anytime, like, I don't really say I do stand-up, but occasionally, like, my mom will, like, tell a neighbor something.
Yeah, it
like,
sucks.
The first thing they always say is, like, I've never heard you say a word.
Yeah. Are you sure that, you're not part Native American?
I would, you know, when Shuli first came by, you had long hair. Yeah. You always wear a starter jacket. And he came by, and I'm like, this ethnically vague guy is pretty fucking funny, dude.
Yeah, he is funny.
I thought you were, like, a Mexican dude or something.
Right now, you look the most Mexican I've ever seen.
This one time, I swear this is true, ate some shrooms with some buddies, and we were, like, walking to catch the L, and this Spanish guy started speaking Spanish to me, and I was like, oh, I don't speak Spanish. And then in perfect English, he was like, are you sure? And then he went right back to speaking Spanish.
Yeah, I've asked you, like, 10 times what the fuck you are.
And there's people I've known for years that, like, think I'm... Because I used to do a lot of, like, crazy bits. Like,
You do crazy bits.
Like, I got my mom to go along with it, too. I convinced all my friends that I was moving to Spain, and, like, I printed out, like, a fake plane ticket and, like, all this shit. And
what kind of bit was this?
You're like a Kaufman, dude.
Yeah. You are a Kaufman. Is this a Kaufman act that you're doing now?
Wasn't it... Didn't you have the idea... Or you're trying to do a podcast with your mom where, like, you did... hallucinogenics with your mom and do like a podcast.
I want to like cut it down to like a film that, you know, like people eating hallucinogens with their parents, especially if it's kind of like not the greatest relationship, and then cut it down into like a short.
It's a sick idea. I remember hearing that. I'm like, God damn, Miss Julie's on the cutting edge.
Because Julie is the cutting edge. Julie, how often are you doing acid?
I slow it down quite a bit.
My thing is how I can't get my dad to do mushrooms without him like trying to kick my ass. So it's like, how could I do that?
Like that's how I feel with because I was like me and my dad would be so much better because we like don't talk like we see each other every day and just like nod.
Your dad's a conservative, isn't he?
I think like most people like he really never cared about politics, but then like the last couple years like. He's been watching, like, a lot of Fox News.
Yeah, he hates walking around seeing his fucking Marxist son like on acid trotting around the house.
Both of them voted... Both my parents voted for Trump, but it's
fuck
like...
Fuck yeah.
They don't, like... They'd both be the first to admit, like, I have no idea, like... I couldn't, like, explain a policy or, like, law to you or, like, anything like that. Like, they voted solely... Yeah.
So them not knowing anything... so your parents know nothing, and you know... stupid information. Who do you think's dumber? You or your dumb fucking parents?
Well, actually, me. I now that I'm like pushing
me.
The last like strong mushroom trip I had, I was just kind of like, oh no, my dad's right about everything. I was like, oh shit, like my mom is an idiot with a checkbook, like. If you know what I mean, like my dad's so.
Your dad's a fucking man.
My dad sounds like the fucking man.
Like he was like, because we rarely talk. And then the other day, he was like, "Hey, you have a late bill for like the doctor." He's
dads
like,
love bills, dude. They love telling their son
like
about
the fucking
bills.
IRS, dude. They're like the other, they're the unspoken branch of the IRS.
He was like, "You don't want to get behind in your finances. Like this is something very important."
I'm telling you, and your dad's Native American too. It's like you don't want to get behind on your finances, son. Your finances
Wait, so
are
you
very
had a mushroom
important,
trip
son.
And you were just like, my dad is totally right about everything.
Yeah.
Yes, dude. That's my favorite thing for a fucking Marxist liberal that does drugs to be like, oh no, my dad loves Fox News and he's right. God
oh,
damn
no,
it.
It's funny, dude. That's exactly that. In a weird way, is Jordan Peterson's appeal. You just one day are like, yeah, my parents are kind of right about a lot of shit, and you're like, fuck. It's just he has a better. Your parents, because I said so. He kind of like explains that. In a way that's not like fuck you, Dad. It's funny though.
Yeah,
that's a tough mushroom trip, dude.
But I mean, I think it's like, dude, my dad's like,
your dad's gonna fuck you up if he hears this, dude.
Like the amount of times that like he's heard he's gonna lose his job or like shit like that, and I think that just like wears on you. You know what I mean? Like he worked at Sears and like he was in the union at Sears, and they were just like. All right, we're closing, like this was years ago, like, in shipping or whatever, you know what I mean? It was just, like, I guess that's, like, a quick realization of, like, it doesn't matter. Like, there was a hospital, I think it's Northeastern, when that closed, like, what they did was they were just like, instead, and so they didn't have to give anybody, like, settlement packages or anything. Yeah, they were just like, we don't have any money and closed down. Yeah, and then just, like, reopened.
Bankruptcy.
Reopened as, like, another hospital.
Dude, I want,
like,
to see you do that podcast like, with your dad on mushrooms, man. That's such a sick idea.
Because I don't know if you've, like, read anything about, like, the studies they've done. I think it's, like, John Hopkins mostly, but, like, with, like, dying people and, like, stuff like that, where, like, they take...
There's a, what's that place in Maryland? The Silver Springs or something? There's
Silver Spring, Maryland.
There's a town in Maryland that the hospital and all the psychedelic research got banned. They were that still kind of went on. So there's an, I think, whatever that's called, Maryland. But yeah, they've been doing all that stuff. And they said for like end of life people, they said really like mushrooms and LSD are really should be for like adults. There's should be this, for like when you're 40, 50 years old.
I heard this thing about like, because like after a certain age, like 40s, 50s, like your brain just kind of is like, okay, these are the things I believe in.
Mm-hmm.
And just like you're not going to like accept new information after like that.
No doubt.
And like they did this experiment where, you know, like people in their 50s ate mushrooms and they were all like, oh, I'm thinking about things completely differently than I like ever have.
Yeah, your dad might do mushrooms and be like, fuck, my son's right about everything.
Yeah. I don't know. I think that sounds like a great idea. You and your dad doing psychedelics together. I would actually rather film you proposing that to your father.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
like, cuz when I dad, I know you're watching Fox and Friends again, but I have this cool podcast idea of like you and me do. I bought mushrooms and I want to take over. Like, I want to take over.
What do you think your mom would take mushrooms with you?
I've got her to be like
it's not bad.
She'll be like, "No, I can't." Yeah, because, like, I'll get, like, shit-faced and be like, yeah, I'm finally going to ask my dad. Like, and then I, like, sober up and I'm like, no, I'm not
going to. You and your dad ever fist fight?
No.
All right,
there's
good,
been
good,
some,
good.
Like...
You should do,
You should knock him out.
You should do lemon tech. You know what lemon tech is for mushrooms?
No.
You grind them up and let them sit in lemon juice for, like, 20 minutes and it breaks the psilocybin down in the psilocin so it doesn't give you, like, that little stomach cramps. And this be like, yo, dad...
Oh, nice. It breaks the psilocybin down from the psilocin?
Yeah, it breaks it into psilocin. You know what people do mushrooms?
That's what I've been so sick of. The fucking
stomach,
psilocin.
Your stomach has to do that. So people get queasy on mushrooms. You break it down, just kicks right in. No stomach upset. And you could dose your dad. You're like, dad, I got to tell you, I did give you mushrooms. But we're on dad. A podcast right now, so don't freak the fuck out.
you took acid.
Like, I could only imagine explain. Because I've been doing a lot of, like, setting up people's podcasts and, like.
Yeah.
Like, the whole thing of, like, going on Libsyn or whatever and, like, doing mm-hmm. it. And, like, I can only imagine trying to explain to him, like, what I do. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like,
You're in the future, dude. You might as well be living on fucking Mars, dude.
Well, it's like when I was going to Temple, like, for audio school, I was like, I'm going to be working in a studio one day making rock albums. And
now
you are.
Now you're in the studio. This is the studio. You're in West Philadelphia. You're on Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast, dude.
True.
That's pretty fucking sick.
Now I'm like, Matt,
your audio
you wanna,
skills are sick, dude. People
want to do
know.
An audiobook, you know?
You're like, you know how, what was it, Beethoven that was deaf?
Yeah.
That's like you with audio work. You can't fucking talk, but you're great at editing podcasts.
That's been my audiobooks recently. All it's about is about like LSD research and how like, I can't wait till that becomes legal. To where, like, you can go sit with like a doctor, a therapist, and then you just take LSD and they just sit there and like talk to you and then you relive your birth. Apparently they say a lot of people have birth trauma to where like you got traumatized at coming out of your mother's vagina in ways that like you don't even remember. To where, like, you got trapped near her.
Yeah, that was the thing, dude. My mom's pussy was so tight. Yeah, I've been so traumatized ever since, dude. I had to bust out of that.
Your fucking head, dude. Imagine, we have big ass heads, dude. I had the umbilical cord around my neck.
I put the umbilical cord around her neck.
Did you when you came out?
I came out and fucking choked her.
Like, what the fuck?
I said, what'd you do to me?
I've been reading about, they'll give people LSD and they start reliving their birth and they're like, oh, I remember it now. And they start talking about when they were born and shit. It's fucking crazy.
Are we fucking boring you?
No, I was looking for. There's this organization.
The fucking phone? Are we wasting your time?
There's this organization called MAPS. I forget what it stands for.
They
don't love you like I love you, do they?
No, MAPS is the Multiple Disciplinary Association of Psychedelic Research.
Yeah, they do a lot of stuff. They've been. And like multiple, they're doing.
MAPS?
Yeah.
Is what?
The Multiple Applied There you go. I said it the first time.
Yeah, well, you didn't say applied. There was no apps.
Yeah, oh, yeah, my bad.
You were like multiple discipline. I was like, sounds like they were on some fucking
psychedelic. No, applied was for. Yeah. Yeah, applied was for. Anyway, it doesn't apps. Matter.
But yeah, they do multiple a lot of.
Multidisciplinary Applied Association of Psychedelic Research, whatever.
Wow.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, whatever. It's not a big deal.
It's just.
Damn, dude. You're just a fucking encyclopedia of.
Hey, man.
Sick knowledge.
I want to join, man.
But yeah, they've been doing a lot of research and like working with like veterans with like PTSD and shit and like trying to
fuck those pussies.
Yeah, they give them fucking Molly.
Yeah, yeah.
They give them
what's ecstasy that shit and shit. Yeah.
What the fuck? What do they call that shit?
DMT.
That's not DMT. You fucking square. don't say DMT.
Are you taking DMT? Are they taking DMT?
What the fuck do they call that stuff?
What do they call ecstasy?
Yeah, like in its purified form.
I forget.
It's not Molly. It's not ecstasy. MDMA. That's what it is. So you give them MDMA, dude, and they say they relive their traumas, dude, and they get over it. Old dying people, apparently. There's like with cigarette smokers and alcoholics. Alcoholics Anonymous was originally founded by a guy. The whole point of it was to give those guys LSD. They just never weren't allowed to do it.
That was the 13th step.
Yeah. Well, the whole idea
trip
was...
balls.
Yeah, dude. Well, they work with people. They would give alcoholics LSD. This was all legal. And they would give it to people. And they're like, yeah, these guys are quitting drinking, quitting smoking, all this
now
stuff.
Now they're just addicted to acid.
You can't become addicted to acid, besides with Shuli.
It is like...
Would you say you can become addicted to acid?
Well, the story was my like best friend OD'd. And then like within like a week, friend and this girl I'd been in love with for years was murdered by her fiance.
It's fucked up.
And I like I in no way like dealt
that's
with
some
it.
Trip.
Yeah, I didn't deal with it in any way, and like I ate mushrooms at her funeral, and then that year I was just eating acid like once a week.
I know kids that did that though.
And I was like, I need this to like
expand your mind.
Yeah, I was like, I'm not dealing with this, like I can't like absorb it, you know what I mean? It was
so you kept trying to go deeper and deeper.
Yeah, and then the one night I was drunk and I accidentally ate like 4 Ace and I fucking like lost it
in 4 Ace
of mushrooms.
Oh Jesus Christ. So you had a half ounce of mushrooms
and I just like lost it in the South Philly house. I was just like screaming and like I burst into like every roommate's room and everyone was like, what are you doing? Because I was just being like, I need someone to help me. Like, I need someone to.
You were shirt off too, weren't you?
Yeah. Oh, pants too. I was just doing naked. Dude, I was like rolling around on the floor like fucking.
Oh my God, dude. That would piss me off so fucking much. Like, here's somebody that's like in desperate need of help and is traumatized. I'd be like, dude, this guy's. I would wait till the next morning and I would talk to the other roommates privately. I'd be like, is he home? He was such a faggot last night, dude. Who the fuck does that shit?
You saw Michelle's coming in for a hug, and you see his hairy asshole, and you're like,
oh my
man.
God.
I mean, I had boxers on, but yeah, I was just like...
Oh, okay.
I was so, like, out of it.
Of course, you ate a half ounce of mushrooms.
Like, I thought I was, like, dead and, like, in this other world, and, like, it got pretty fucking...
I ate 6 grams of mushrooms one time, which not even half of what you ate, and I was convinced I could never tell the difference between night and day ever again. It was 4 o'clock in the morning. I was looking out my window like, it's kind of both right now. And I was like, fuck. Shit. That's what I think they should legalize this stuff and have, like, you should have to go to, like, a center. To where, like, they know it's totally, like, it's not cut with, like, especially acid, not cut with weird shit. And you have a guy who's like, all right, they test you. They, like, talk to you. And they're like, all right, man, like, you're kind of a fucking wingnut. You're not going to do this. You're cool. We'll give you this much. And then you can sit there and do it. It'd be fucking awesome. But I also know people went off the deep end. I know guys who were doing acid like every weekend, all the time. And I will say, man, that shit can go bad for people.
Yeah.
I know a guy who has...
Yeah, definitely.
Like real bad.
His fucking friend died.
Well, it wasn't from acid.
Oh, I can't... We probably shouldn't talk about that.
Yeah, my bad.
No, because I was about to say that and then I was like, oh, I probably shouldn't.
Yeah.
It wasn't... My bad. No, it's all
but
good.
Yeah, I think if like people with like... that have like a history of mental illness and like the family and stuff and like if you just start taking drugs like that, it's like it can definitely have effects.
Well, that's the other thing too, if no one tells you know, if you have a buttoned up dad, he's not gonna be like, yo, by the way, keep on the lookout for this shit.
Yeah, it's the fire of the gods, dude.
It is, dude. Well, dude, I know
steal the fire of the gods.
I know this one guy who, dude, he was like such a weird motherfucker, dude. And I met these, I knew all these kids that that's all they're doing all the time. And it's funny, I watched them over a course of like 7 years, like, you know, what they've been up to. And this one guy called me the one time. Did I tell you about this? When he tried to like, he told me he had a dog for me. It turned out he just stole it from some other kid I knew. It was like, he was pissed at him for like robbing his money. These were, I like knew all these evil hippies for a while. And he like
I fucking hate evil hippies.
He ransomed some guy's dog. And then like when like the shit hit the bricks, everyone's like, dude, we're going to come fuck you up. And if you don't get that, he's like, I'm across your house. I got this dog, man. It's a good dog. And I'm like, what the fuck? I don't want a dog. Right? What am I going to do with that? And barely stole it from this other guy I knew. But that guy, I watched him. Like, I'd see him once a year for years. And like, you know, he got real weird. He'd call me about the dog. I'm like, yo, bro, I don't want a fucking dog. Next year, I see him. He was a sushi chef at Whole Foods. I'm like, yo, bro, look at you, man. You got a little gig. That's what's up. And he goes, yeah, dude, I'm doing my part. You know, there's a battle of good and evil going on. I'm like, all right, what the fuck, man? So I'm like, you know, I don't see him again for 3 years. Then him and some other kid I knew had some weird dealing that went on. We're like, these are evil. They had some evil hippie deal where I think he like sold this guy weed. The guy had the weed. And then he was like, I want to return it to you. The guy was like, no fucking dice. Fuck you. So then this guy who, you know, was like a sushi chef showed up at the dog park where this kid has his dog playing in a full like Neo fucking Matrix duster with like shades on and like black pants and just sat there and stared at him. And this guy had to be like, people at the dog park to this other dude, and they were like, yo, who the fuck is that guy? And they're like, I don't know, it's some fucking guy I know. And he'd be like, you know what you did, dude.
Oh, my God.
I've seen people go full off, like, you know. But I think that's when you're kind of fucked up in general.
Dude, evil hippies.
Dude, no one knows about the evil hippie world, man.
People ask me, like, what's your problem with Del Cala? I'm like, he's an evil hippie, dude.
Del Cala's a bit of an evil hippie.
Del Cala's a secret evil hippie.
Okay, I'll give you that, man.
People don't see that he's an evil hippie. Del Cala, I'm onto your fucking games, dude. I know you're a fucking evil hippie, dude. John Nunn, evil hippie.
He could be an evil hippie.
He's a very friendly guy, but he's done some evil hippie dealings, dude. He's an evil hippie dealer.
Okay.
You
gotta watch. They are, dude. Because
Christian and the boys. Evil hippie.
Oh my God, yeah.
Very evil hippie.
You gotta watch, man. They don't even live in this realm of like number. I watched two guys simultaneously owe each other money one time. The same amount. I was just kind of like, yeah, but dude, like, remember that one time? Like, I smoked you out twice. Like, yeah, but dude, I introduced you to that one girl who buys Molly off of you, so that's like $60.
Evil hippies love pussy, too, dude.
Dude, oh my God. They do, but evil girls who are evil hippies, the pussy
there's
they
a ton
get
of evil hippies.
Oh, fucking.
Those are witches.
Yeah, they are.
It's evil hippies and brujas.
They are brujas, dude.
Manny brujas.
The best. I knew a girl one time. Same thing as this whole hippie house down like in Southwest Philly, and this girl was like trying to get her other evil hippie friend to. She got a rent check from her grandmom every month, but she didn't have a bank account. She didn't support banks. She's like, I don't trust banks.
Classic evil hippie.
I don't. But she's like, but could you use your bank to like cash this check? And I'm like, why don't you just have your grandma? Why don't you just like do it in your account or like set a joint account with your grandma? She was like, well, I actually add, like, I tell my grandma her rent's like $200 more than it actually is, so like I don't want her to see that. I'm like, oh, dude, but you're stealing from your grandma, you evil little bitch. Yeah.
That's all right. I did name some evil hippies, and I don't want them to fall into this definition. It's just a funny thing to call them.
It is, no, exactly.
But evil hippies are definitely people that do drugs,
yes,
and act like hippies. They have those values of like, oh man, chill, be peaceful, yeah, and then yeah, hide behind those values to commit shit like stealing money from their grandma.
Yep.
Like, I actually don't believe in banks.
Yeah. And they'll rip.
And then they'll fucking steal.
I watch them rip people. I've seen one guy rip off his friend for $50 right in front of me. And
like,
I knew he was doing
talking
it.
To chicks, being like, oh yeah, that's so fucking chill.
Oh dude, wait, what do you do? That's
crazy. Oh wow. Like, here's my energies. Here's some crystals. It's like they're just trying to fuck this chick. They're evil hippie.
I knew the one guy when I just got married. I still was like in this evil hippie network, dude. And I remember he fucking. I like just brought my fucking ex-wife to like Mexico. I spent all this money. And then like this, I spent like four fucking grand on this trip. And then I watched this guy with his fucking hippie girlfriend. And he just literally, he showed her a quartz crystal he got her. And this chick was like to the fucking moon about it. And I was looking at him as like,
you fucking asshole.
What the fuck, man?
I gotta take my bitch to sandals to get this reaction.
What the fuck, man?
Yeah, you two though. I'm looking at two guys that could have very easily fallen into the evil hippie realm, and instead,
we're kinda, shamans, dude. We're just
you guys
fucking,
both kind of found your own lane of just crazy shit.
We're just me and Mishuli are just space debris.
You guys
are
literally just hurling through space.
We've definitely been like sharing a lot of like books and videos. Of, yeah, like, dude. I'm like, oh, I just read this. You should read this.
Everything Mishuli gives me. I'm like, awesome. Shuli's book recommendations are fucking top notch.
you two dealing with each other just is so funny to think of. You two like communicating, like, actually, Trump was on the plane also. And you're like, exactly, dude, the fucking Clintons are on there, dude. Imagine that. Think of all those, all that combining.
You ever see Arrival? You ever see the movie Arrival?
Yes.
Like these squids come from the future and like they're communicating and it's just like these weird moon ruins that float across.
Yes.
It's how me and Michelle talk.
That is how you guys talk. You're like, you should check out this book about like capitalism. And you're like, yeah, exactly, man. There's
dude, Michelle's book wrecks are good.
You guys should start a book club. Take a fucking...
It should be called...
It's called like... And all you do is take a dab of acid and read a book about like the government.
No, but Shirley sends me novels, dude. Literary fiction. They're fantastic.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, dude, I'm saying though, more people, hopefully in the future, when I am really excited for people to legalize like little mushroom sessions. For like, imagine your fucking dad dealing with his impending death. They should be able to take mushrooms and like come to grips with like cancer and shit.
Nah, fuck that. They should be out just crushing it with light beer and sports, dude. No, dude. That's how an old man handles. No. That's how you handle death.
My dad has that same shit too. He has the fucking skin cancer shit. And we have this lady will come like once a month. They're having a lady come and clean the house and shit. Cleaning lady, 1%. I'll admit it. And
damn, you guys got a cleaning lady?
Yeah, she'll come through and clean.
What do you think of that, Schultz?
Hey, it's employment.
Schultz is gonna try to get her to rise up against your family. That's
trickle down, dude.
Like we should.
It was like a lady would come through once a month. It wasn't like a live-in fucking, which would be sick, but it was
she
just
had
like
a nanny.
Yeah, hiring like a cleaning
she
lady.
She had a fucking mammy.
Yeah, it was like a hired lady who came. This Mexican chick, and my dad came back from like one of his treatments where like they put the shit all over his face. He had like his sunglasses on, and the lady just couldn't speak any English. She stopped. She's like, "You look like Michael Jackson." And dude, my dad was just like, "You think that's funny? You think that's funny?" And he was so fucking mad. She pwned him in front of everyone. Everyone was like, "Ah."
She couldn't even speak English, and she pwned.
Just crushed
him. Pwned somebody in their house in a different language.
Dude, it was so. You look like Miguel Jackson.
Miguel Jackson.
Dude, it was so funny.
That is hilarious.
Old men are all getting it now, dude. And that's all.
Yeah, old men are dying
from them being like. Fucking sunscreen, dude. I used to do demolition with my dad and all my uncles. Asbestos flying around. Dude, they're just like, be all right, dude. Come on, man. I used to do a thing where like we would cut out drop ceilings and literally dry pigeon shit. It was a bare concrete floor. And you drop the ceiling. And then afterwards, there was just an inch thick of pigeon shit. And then all the dry pigeon shit floating around. Like you could see it, the dust of pigeon shit floating. And they're like, she'll be all right, dude. You don't need a man. I'm like, that's how you get fucking disease. You breathe the shit in. I like research pigeon shit. You have to wet it to activate the fucking virus of it. Dry pigeon shit's fine. So when you breathe it in, your inside of you's wet and it activates all the fucking shit.
Activates the pigeon shit.
The germs freeze dry themselves. Whatever, a bird flu. It freezes. It's just dry freezed and dry pigeon
is
shit.
Is that what freezing looks like?
When I cross my arms.
Brett's doing
my
an
chest.
Act out of freezing right now.
Yeah, man. The old man Hardo shit, dude, is like, I'm the last of a dying breed, dude. I'm the last old man Hardo, dude. I'll be like the last generation.
You think you're an old man Hardo?
Yeah, bro.
I think you're the first, you're the new breed of old man Hardo.
That's what I'm saying, dude.
Of like, I gotta Google what the fuck this is gonna do to me.
True that.
And then warn the others.
I'm trying to.
No, you're just, you're like, yeah, we should cut the ceiling out.
Yeah.
But we should also Google what pigeon shit does.
They didn't care, dude. When we were
running, that's the ancient old man Hardo. That's just like we're born to die, dude. We gotta go in there and breed this pigeon shit.
Dude, we were in a building. We were inside of a building with machines running, diesel machines, and we weren't allowed to bust the windows out because the windows were like an asbestos caulk frame. So you're not allowed to open windows or anything. And I was just in like diesel smoke's blue, so everywhere around me was just blue tinted. Then by the end of the day, you'd walk out of there and be like, fucking Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's got to be so bad
for you.
Then
I finally cut a hole. I like in the door, it was like a metal door. So I burnt, like you take a torch and you burn the metal and you make like a big hole. I did it both sides. The smoke, just a little cross breeze. Finally, the next day, they're like, hey, it's a little better in here. It's kind of nice. It's like, you motherfuckers, man. They couldn't do it. Because they couldn't be the one to be like, it's too much in here. It's hilarious, dude.
You're the canary. You're down the coal mine, dying. I'm letting the boys know.
I was derelict, dude. I was down there. I was like, Pa, I think I have the black lung.
What are we at time-wise here?
Hour and 23.
Wow. That's it. Wow. What a great episode. James.
In the books, dude.
I mean, you came in here and just changed the way we think. You presented several arguments very well.
You know what's funny? I know this. Michelle's going to have just like a wealth of fucking communistic knowledge just hit him. As soon as we turn the mics off,
turn it off,
it's all going to come back. Yeah. It's like, wait. It all made sense. Happens to me all the time.
Tell us why we should be communists like you.
Yo, give us the final word, dude.
Yeah, give us a rundown on why you're a fucking Marxist communist.
No, it's good to be here, and
that's your fucking answer.
Oh, I just think, you know, I mean, you voted for Obama. I didn't. That's
all. I didn't vote for Obama.
Flame shame.
I've never voted in my
Whoa,
life.
Whoa, Shane Gillis exposed.
I did not vote for. I ain't no vote for no Obama.
I love how that's you exposed.
I did not vote for Obama. Oh, don't you?
I thought he said he did. Actually, I remember.
I probably said I have. I probably lied before. I've never voted in a presidential.
You lied about voting for Obama.
I've never voted in a presidential election.
That's such a sick move to be like anyone. I can be like I voted
for Obama.
I swear you said it before too.
I probably have said that.
Yeah. Surely knows.
I mean, Shuli's like a fucking steel trap with all that. he hears one of us say something liberal and he's like, yeah, I know they're faking it. Because he's morally, he can't listen to the Matt and Shane Secret Podcast morally, but he's like,
oh, he totally can listen to it morally.
He's got to be like, I'm in on the joke. They're definitely also Marxists.
Shelly's one of my favorite people in the world.
Wow, that's hilarious. If I've said I voted for Obama.
You definitely did now, think about it.
I did not vote for Barack Obama. That is on the record. If I ever said that, which I probably, now that I'm thinking about it, I had to have said it multiple times.
Definitely. You did.
I never said
it. Shelly is the beacon of truth.
I'm telling you
dude.
Right now, I never did.
Shelly is the holy water you look into and see your true reflection. You go, I did that?
I would have voted for McCain the first time. And then the second time I didn't vote.
You smashed the fucking Obama button, dude.
I love Obama. I voted for him. I did vote for Obama. I voted for him twice.
Damn, that's funny.
I did not vote for Obama.
Surely wins the episode, dude. That's it. He had that fucking, he had that dagger in his back pocket.
Wait,
dude.
Do you think it's bad if I did?
No, I'm kidding.
Or lied? Which one do you think is worse?
If you lied about it, I guess. I don't think anyone's
worse. No, I didn't vote for Obama.
I don't know if you did. I don't care if you did.
Really did not.
It's a sweet thing to be like, if you're about to say something kind of fucked up, like, I voted for Obama.
I voted for Obama. I thought he was a great president.
Dude, that's so funny, man.
All right, so why should we be communists?
No, I just think, you know, in these times, especially with, you know, all the apps.
Are you sweating? Sweating so much, dude.
But you know what I'm thinking is like...
Especially with the apps.
What if they invent robots you can fuck that are like... Literally, it's like fucking a real chick. Will you become Amazon slave if they can fuck a hot robot forever? And you can honestly make it pregnant and have a little robot baby. That grows up... I'm not going to get into that because... Well, would you...
What's it grow up into?
I was going to say you could fuck that too, but it's like that's
and
a
then
robo
you can fuck
daughter.
Your robot daughter?
No, yeah, well, it's a robot though. So like you just got, I don't know, I'm not going to even get into this, dude. This is just, this
you
is
shouldn't
just,
even be on the air right now.
What about that though? What do you think about fucking like a robot baby that you created? Not the baby, dude, you let it grow. You let it grow to like 18.
Hold on a sec, because I do want to hear your answer on would you fuck your robot child. But,
no, your robot...
Either
beautiful
way,
teenage,
overlord.
Beautiful, like, you know, 30-year-old dog.
Why are you so sweaty right now?
I don't know.
He's, like, very visibly sweaty on his forehead.
Well, you put him on the fucking spot, dude.
Are you wearing a fucking wire right now,
you're like
now,
a human
dude?
Floodlight, dude.
That's what happens.
I don't think I can fuck a machine, though. Even those, like...
Even a fleshlight?
The ones that are, like, connect to your... Did you ever see those?
No,
it's
what?
It's, like... They have like special scenes, and then it's like the fucking fleshlight like moves with
goes with what's happening in the scene.
Yeah.
Oh, the VR porn, dude.
And that too.
Wait, dude. So this is the fleshlight that like rides to the rhythm of like the chick in the scene.
Yeah, yeah. It's like a like USB connected, and then like you take it off, and you like they're like specially made scenes by this company or whatever, and they like interact with the fucking fleshlight.
That's too much, man. That to me is like when it becomes too much. But a hot robot that can reproduce a child, That you maybe you could.
How long would the term last? How long would they be pregnant?
Okay, you couldn't fuck the robot that popped out of the other robot, but you could surely sell it.
You could give it to your friends.
Yes, sell it.
I'm not. You gotta hook it up with your. You gotta hook your boys up.
Give away hot robo pussy. I'd pimp it.
You'd pimp out. You'd have a nice stable of robo pussy.
Yeah, dude, I'd be pimping.
How much do they look like humans? Is this like Westworld?
They look exactly like me.
Well, then I'd buy it. I would buy it and fuck its ass. So, James, why should we be communists?
Just all I'm saying is, you know, you got to think about the average person, you know, the worker, and just yeah.
Have you met a worker? They fucking suck. Have you met a fucking worker, a manual labor worker? They fucking stink, dude. I despise
them. Well, I do manual labor, dude.
Yeah, and you suck.
No, I don't, dude. I was painting for 2 weeks. I need to do manual labor every 2 weeks.
I live in New
York. I'm real salt of the earth.
I live in New York, dude. I voted for Obama twice, and I live in New York. Please. Please.
Please, dude.
Please.
Dude, I was down on my hands and knees, dude, in other people's houses today. Just making their houses look pretty, dude. Just letting it trickle down on me. I love the 1%, dude.
You love the 1%?
Love the 1%.
You like that trickle down economics?
It trickled down right on me, dude.
Will the robot squirt?
No doubt.
Will that trickle down upon you?
Ooh, yeah.
You got
yeah.
a squirting robot?
Yeah. They'd have to squirt.
And these are Westworld bots?
Yeah.
Or are these are hot Westworld robots? Yeah. Yeah. And then I would fuck the robot kid, too.
Eventually.
Ooh. How about that for a cure for pedophilia? Just what? Give them some fucking Westworld bot kids.
Well, being in the entertainment, and I can see why you're trying to normalize pedophilia being in the entertainment industry, but that's my red line.
You draw
dude.
The line.
That's my red line, dude.
Are you going to be like Obama with a red line on chemical weapons?
Yeah, then you'll fuck a robot kid.
I'll fuck a robot kid.
Well,
Shane's like,
still cool. He's all right.
Well, what am I going to do? Fight him? Dude, how much do you love Obama, you communist fucking bitch?
Yeah, do you like Obama?
I didn't vote for him, or
I did.
Shane lie voted for him, dude. That's so fucking funny. You lied about voting for Obama.
I never voted for Obama. I'll explain why after the episode.
Okay.
Pretty,
that's fair.
Pretty reasonable. I'll tell you why. It's actually fucked up. If you subscribe to the Patreon, I'll tell you.
I'll whisper it in your ear.
I'll whisper it.
That's really funny. I think we got it, bro. It's an hour and a half.
Yeah, let's call it. We're not going anywhere right now.
No, we're good.
This thing's off.
All right. Thank you again,
that's
Mishuli.
What you get, dude.
You're a motherfucking man.
Thanks for having me.
James Mishuli, dude. Check him out. Anything you want to plug?
No.
You got that mic you run, right? What's that mic?
Oh, Sunday night, Fergie's Pub.
Sunday night at Fergie's Pub. Check out James Mishuli.
Me and the U Up crew. Sign up to
Shut up, shut up, shut up.
U Up crew, baby.
Shut
Love
up.
It. What up?
August 22nd. We didn't plug it at all.
Yes.
Have we plugged it on here?
No,
August, we didn't. August 22nd. Me and Matt, Secret Podcast
Secret
Live. Mishuli will be in the fucking sound booth running the board.
Yep.
Live podcast, Helium Comedy Club, mm-hmm. August 22nd. If you're not there, you fucking get it. Undoubtedly. Let's go.
Let's go, baby.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel.